In this video, we are going to be playing with spikes and peaks and showing you how to convert using AccuQuilt. Let's break it down and make some quilts. Hello, all you piecers out there. We are so excited to be back with you for another program. So, Spikes and Peaks has been a book that has been very, very popular. It's out of print. We have made it available as a download, as a PDF download. You may find a printed copy in stock somewhere. I never know about that. And we decided that we would play in Spikes and Peaks. But then I thought, well, wait a minute. Maybe you guys have done some of that, and what could I do that would make it more exciting? After playing in the book myself over the last week or two, I realized there are 10 quilts in the Spikes and Peaks book, or 10 projects. All 10 of them can be done using AccuQuilt. But in this one, I'm going to give you AccuQuilt for every project that we're working on. There's only one or two exceptions in the book that are a little tricky, but I can walk you through it. If you read, when you look at the Spikes and Peaks book, it clearly states it is written exclusively for specialty rulers. There are no traditional directions in this book. So obviously you would need your specialty ruler of some sort, some brand, if you were going to make the quilts in the book. For those of you who are not familiar with AccuQuilt, we have a spot below that you can click on, get a little bit more information, go to your local quilt shop. There are loads and loads of AccuQuilt dealers around the country. Go in and get a little bit of information about it. Now, the quilt that you see behind me is the cover quilt for the Spikes and Peaks book. It is called Points and Peaks. That's a little bit of peas, isn't it? My approach and what I'm anticipating we'll be doing is we'll do maybe 3 sessions after we do this introduction, and I'm going to be able to combine techniques and say, okay, everything I'm doing right here will make quilt 1, quilt 2, and quilt 3. Then the next time we'll do things that'll make quilt 4, quilt 5, and quilt 6. So each time I do this, I will give you the AccuQuilt die numbers that will translate to making that project. Right now I hear questions. Which size cube is it gonna be, Kate? For those of you who own AccuQuilt cubes, you know that it doesn't make any difference which size you use. It just means your quilt will be smaller or larger. If you want to make the exact size that this pattern calls for, the 8-inch cube would be your go-to. But it doesn't matter if you have the 6, the 8, the 9, the 10, or the 12, yours will just be a little bit larger, a little bit smaller. And then I'm also going to show you how to do it with a specialty ruler, but those directions are in the book. But I'm even going to give you a few little tips that aren't in the book that will make this a little bit worthwhile. Now, I'm sure somebody's going, okay, how much is this going to cost me? Spikes and Peaks book was a retail of $21.95. We have it as a download as $5. That's your cost for the program, folks, is $5. Now, needless to say, I understand that you're going to be printing these off, and we certainly hope that everyone prints their own copies, because for $5, we're going to spend quite a bit of time and give you a boatload of technique. Now, at the end of the session, there will be a free download chart for converting the entire book to AccuQuilt, but it will only be released as we work through the sessions. I'm not going to do that first. So, to cut to the chase, here's what we're going to be doing. We're going to take this book, we're going to be using AccuQuilt dies and or specialty rulers, and there are loads of brands in the industry. I will talk about the one I'm working with, but if you have another one, it's going to do the trick. I have a brand new collection, which is part of Wilmington's Essential line. And for those of you who might not be aware of that, it's like their basic collection. They have loads and loads and loads of patterns, and each pattern will have about 16 colorways of that pattern. The quilt that you see behind me, that's my favorite way of working. The quilt that I'm making with you in the first session is this. So in other words, I'm going to be working a little bit out of my comfort zone, but I'm so excited that to have this line, and it has just shipped, so it is in stores. You do not need a fabric pack for this. This is the best quilt in the world to work out of your stash. And as you look at the quilt behind me, I probably have 30 different backgrounds in there. I mean, I could just pick a scrap up and go, okay, I can cut a square out of that one. I can cut a square out of that one. I can cut a triangle out of that one. If you want to plan it, then yes, you will need to follow the yardage chart that's given to you once you download your pattern. You could follow that yardage chart, but I am telling you, I encourage you to do nothing until we do this first session and then make the block with just scrap fabrics to then decide which way you're going to go. So for those of you who know AccuQuilt, I'm going to tell you right now which ones you're going to need to make this first quilt. So your job is going to be then to go through your stash, see what you own, and make your decision. But you can use the AccuQuilt dies that live in your basic cube and then use ruler technique to do the ones that you don't own. So if you own a cube of any size, I will be making mine with the 8-inch cube. You can do anything. You will need die 1, 2, 5, 9, and 14 to execute this quilt. And even if you have the smallest cutter, you will be able to execute this with no problem. Also, let me make it clear, I do not work for AccuQuilt. I am not a certified teacher for AccuQuilt. I love the product. I think it has simplified lots of things. And when we run into these angles and the scrappiness and the fact that I can layer up 6 pieces and jump through this at one time, has made it one of my favorite methods when I need a lot of different elements. So I'm gonna be working with half squares, I'm gonna be working with some weird angles, some half rectangles, but please do not let the fabric have any issue in this. You can use leftovers from any of our previous projects and you're ready to go. This quilt behind me truly was out of my scrap basket. For any of those viewing us for the first time, we have a Facebook page called Staycation. And that's where we started when this COVID situation broke with all of our programs. And we've done a couple of spinoffs. You can visit us there and or the K England publication page, and all of those are listed below as well. Spikes and Peaks is our next playground. We can't wait to see you again. Bye-bye.